Welcome to Freed on Business. He grew up in South Florida, has been in business here since the early 90s, and has closed over $3 billion in deals. He's seen it all. He always has an opinion, and he's always ready to share it. Informed, entertaining, and connected, he has his finger on the pulse of South Florida's business community. He's Jim Freed, and this is Freed on Business.
Well, we've got another great edition of Freed on Business. This week, I'm inspired and motivated by a lot of my friends that have reached out to me and asked me, what's the secret to podcasting? How can they use podcasting to build their brand? Wow, Jim, we think you do this really tremendous. How can we do this? So Mr. Mendoza and I will talk about what goes into producing the podcast, who can do a podcast, how can you do a podcast, where do you got to be to do a podcast, how do you get guests to be on a podcast, and all kinds of other questions that we've answered. But I think if you're watching this now, you already know what we use the podcast for and how we use it to build our brand. So Mr. Mendoza, take it away. Let's talk about cars. Then we'll come back and we'll talk about building your personal brand with a podcast. All right. Hey, I'm Jim Freed, and we're here on Freed on Business. We want to thank our sponsors for now going on a 10th year. It's actually our 11th year being sponsored by Warren Henry Automotive. We want to thank our friends at Warren Henry for allowing us to be their brand ambassador for over a decade. Thank you so much to Warren Zinn, Larry Zinn, Eric Day, and the rest of the team over at Warren Henry Automotive. And remember, when you're looking to buy or lease a car, you want to make sure you get every advantage that you can. That's why you always have to check out Warren Henry, Land Rover, Range Rover, Infiniti, and Jaguar up at 151st and Biscayne. In Gainesville, they sell their Audis. I'm going to go up there and check out the Audi store in the next couple of weeks in Gainesville. And then down in the Keys, they've got everything down there, including those fancy Jeep cars that you see all over the place. They're just so smoking great. What do all those cars have in common? Well, they're all great cars, and they all come with Warren Henry Advantage. It's a whole list of services that you get. It includes complimentary service loaner. They'll polish up your wheels if you scrape them up against the curb. They'll make sure that you can replace your keys. Those keys cost a lot of money, hundreds of dollars. And of course, they'll guarantee you get the best price on your trade-in, the best price on your new car. And if you don't like your car, they give you 3 days to turn it back to them. Nobody ever does that because these are just tremendous cars. So join me, my beautiful wife, Vivian, lots and lots of my friends, my mom. We're all members of the Warren Henry family. You should be too. Always the best price, always the best service, always Warren Henry.
Carlson from Carlson Integrated. You know, a lot of our clients find that they can do anything, but not really everything. We are always excited to jump in and help. So whether you need another set of hands for a project or even comprehensive marketing management, our team of marketing mavens would love to have a conversation with you to see if we are the right fit. We do everything from logo and design work to email outreach and social media to writing and thought leadership. And here's a fun one. We are now offering our fabulous ebook of top 10 marketing tips on our website for free. So head over to carlsonintegrated.com and grab a copy today. And please always let us know how we can help. My email is Becca, that's B-E-K-A-H at carlsonintegrated.com. That's B-E-K-A-H at carlsonintegrated.com.
There she is. Rebecca Carlson, part of my branding team. Lots of things go into my brand, including the fact that I'm related to a lot of things with the University of Florida Center for Real Estate Studies. They're one of the sponsors on the show as well. Hey, reach out to me. Give me a call. DM me. Well, you're seeing one of the reasons you should do it right now. I'm adept at many different things, and I work with families all across the world to help them deploy capital and do real estate investments right here. right here in Florida and across the country. Actually, we're doing deals right now in Chicago and Texas. We did one last year in the Carolinas. We're looking at one in Georgia right now, and of course across the state of Florida, all the different product types. And we had Brewster Kell on a couple of days ago. We were interviewing him for a show that we're going to play later on in the year. And what Bruce was saying was, Jim, you do all these different things, but what is it, the one thing that you really do? What the one thing I really do is I help people solve their real estate problems. Operating companies, big investment companies, people from overseas, Latin America, the Middle East, plantation, all over the state, all over the country. The one thing it all has in common is that when you reach out to me, it's always all about you.
Welcome back to Freedom Business. Connect with us on LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter at Jim Fried or at Freedom Business, and on Instagram at Jim Fried One. Now, back to your host, Jim Fried.
Okay, we're back with another edition of Freedom Business. This one's all about you. It's how do you have a blog? We'll talk about the things that I've done over the past year and how I even decided over the past years and how I decided to have a blog. Really, it was forced on me right after the pandemic started. Up until then, I was broadcasting live on radio on 880 AM, The Biz, here in Miami in South Florida. And the network was sold, the station was sold, and it went automatic all day religious programming. So I needed to find a new place to do my radio show. So first we went to one of these underground radio stations, didn't really work out that well. And then the pandemic hit. And Mr. Mendoza, psst, where are you?
Hey,
there he is. Mr. Mendoza suggested, hey, there's something new that you should be looking into. I go, oh yeah, what's that? He goes, Zoom. I go, what the heck is that? Well, I think we all found out what Zoom is. Mr. Mendoza, high five to you on that.
Quickly. Yeah. Well, we had to, right? We had to, we had to adapt to the circumstances.
Well, we changed. And see, the first thing that we did was you know, we started doing this, but it wasn't our first rodeo. I mean, this, we must have 650, 700, episodes in the can before we went to Zoom. And, you know, so let's start with the first part that people talk to me about when they want to do one of these blog type things. Sure. They go, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
About what?
Well, I look, it's a very natural fear. And a lot of people that are willing to, that are interested in starting out a podcast, just to be clear, a podcast is an audio format. A video podcast would be a video and audio format. And then a blog is written word. They can be very similar in content, but there's, you know, obviously certain differences in that. But to get back to your question, there's a lot of fears that come along with it. There's the fear of doing something, trying something new. There's a fear of public speaking. Ultimately, I think that there is a fear of failure, which is normal. And it's what we all have and we all go through, whether we're starting a podcast or starting a business or branching out on our own or starting a new job, starting a family. It's completely normal. It's a completely normal human thing. And it is overcomable.
One of the best ways to do it is to surround yourself with people who've been there before, which is one of the reasons why a lot of my friends are starting to look to me to team up with them to show them how to do it. And that's sort of what we're going to do here on the show today.
Absolutely. So I agree with you. I would make one small note to that. And I think that there's two ways of doing that. There's one is to do it all your own and become, you know, obsessive with devouring the information and learning everything that you can, because not only do you have to learn how to do it, but you're also going to have to learn how to avoid all of the pitfalls and the things that come along. Or your way, which I agree with, which is to bring people, surround yourself with people that have been there before and that can help you through it. That can also be part of your process, you know, part of your personal process. But I think not all of us have the time. I went the first way. I went the way of just devouring everything I could and learning as much about it and staying on top of it. And that's how I got involved in it, you know, years and years and years ago. But I don't think that that's necessarily ideal for everyone. I don't know if that's something that I could do now. I have two kids. I didn't have two kids before. Now I have two kids that are in preschool and I'm running after them, you know, after dinner. Before I had, you know, an hour or two after dinner to, you know, roam the internet looking, going down rabbit holes, finding solutions to, you know, to the problems that I was having. I have to be much better with my time management now. So now when I need, now when I'm starting out new things, I'm leaning on other people and I'm looking for help and guidance.
Well, that's the whole thing. And you know, there's a variety of different ways to do it. The person can be coached and guided by us, or we can also interview them. And some of our interviews are used by the people that we interview as a one-time blog post. But I'm finding now that many of them are coming back to me and looking to create their own content, either within our show on a regular basis, like we do with Olivia, for instance,
sure.
Or to have their own freestanding show. And I'm talking to a number of different people like that right now. You know, and then I'm going to have to leverage you, because it's not my primary function either. It's really an adjunct that I use strictly for marketing and for relationship building.
And
I think that's an important thing to point out, is it's not only about the information, it's about the people that you're affiliating with and building the relationship with.
That's right. I, you know, as you mentioned, we met each other at the radio station. That's one of the first ways I got into podcasting. Before that, I was working at recording studios and doing post-production. So I've been around the industry for, you know, most of my adult life, probably about 20 years or so now. So yeah, I would say that the relationship building is an extremely important and sometimes overlooked part. People focus a lot of times, they sort of get a tunnel vision on, which is good, but they sort of get some tunnel vision on creating the content. Oh, who am I going to line up? What am I going to talk about? How am I going to get it started? How am I going to get it out to all the different platforms? That's fantastic. But I will tell you right now is that I, you know, if people were interested in helping us guide them through it, that's stuff that we can do. That's stuff I can do. And the relationship building part is really what's important. I've seen people at the station recording their podcasts, coming in and recording, not necessarily doing it live, coming in and recording, bringing in their guests, doing the podcast, and then just hanging out and talking business. Because now all of a sudden you're there, everyone feels good, you're very familiar with each other because you've just got done talking to each other for a half hour or whatever it is. And so now is a good time to, you know, to further that relationship, or maybe to, you know, to talk some shop, maybe to talk some business.
You see, the podcaster has to realize that it's not about them, that it's about the guest and about the listener. I think that's a really big part of the podcast thing when it doesn't really go right, is the person's using it to project themselves in an overt way when it should really be very subtle. Let's take a quick break, and then we're going to talk about how, you know, what is your brand? How do you project that on the podcast, and some of the nuances and technical problems that we've been able to solve over time that people will run into.
Let's do it.
You got it. Hi, you know, I'm Jim Fried. This is our Fried on Business podcast. We're talking about how to do a podcast to build your brand. That's the show today. And I'd really like to thank our sponsors now for our second decade. We're now in our 11th season being sponsored by Warren Henry Automotive. I want to thank Eric Day, Larry's Inn, and of course, Warren's Inn for always being there for us through all of the ups and downs that have occurred over the last decade. One thing has remained solid, and that's our relationship with Warren Henry. It's great to be part of that Warren Henry family. And you too can be part of the Warren Henry family. If you're looking to buy or lease a car, you want to make sure you get every advantage that you can. That's why you have to check out Warren Henry, Land Rover, Range Rover, Infiniti, and Jaguar up at 151st and Biscayne. I'm going to be going to Gainesville in the next few weeks, and I'll be stopping up at their store on Main Street in Gainesville. I'll be looking at the Audis, maybe an A6, maybe an A8. Maybe something else, but I'll be looking up there. And of course, down in the Keys, they have in Key West, their store down there where they have all the great nameplates. What do all those cars have in common? Well, they're all great cars, and they all come with the Warren Henry Advantage. That means complimentary service loaner. You get, they'll polish up your rims. I always look down there like I'm looking at the rims. If you scrape them up, they'll make sure you get your keys replaced. Those are really expensive. They'll make sure you get the best price on your used, on your car you're turning in, on your new car. And of course, they will give you 3 days to make sure you like your car. If you don't, you can turn it back. Nobody turns their car back. They all love them. Those are tremendous cars. So join me, my beautiful wife, Vivian, my mom, lots and lots of my friends. We're all members of the Warren Henry family. You should be too. Always the best price, always the best service, always Warren Henry.
Can AI supercharge your real estate analysts? With DeepBlocks, you can now canvas entire cities in minutes. Search by total buildable, potential units, and uses allowed. Now live in 100 cities. Book a private demo and supercharge your real estate analysts. DeepBlocks.com/demo.
That is such a tremendous product. Olivia gave me a demo the other day about their updated version. It took about 15 minutes. We found all kinds of opportunities. I'm telling you, that's one great platform. Reach out to me. You see that I'm connected with a whole bunch of people. If you hear what we do with the branding, you know that I build relationships with the blog, and you know I have tremendous relationships because you see a lot of the people on the blog and the other on the podcast and the other people that you don't see. Well, when you go out in public and you see me with them, you'll know who the people are that I can network with. But the bottom line is, what do I really do? I help people solve their real estate problems. I have clients from the Middle East, from the Far East, from New Zealand, from all over the state of Florida, all over the United States. We're doing business in Chicago, in Texas, in the Carolinas, in Georgia. We've got projects going everywhere with these institutions, and I do business with the largest real estate institutions in the world, life companies, insurance companies, balance sheet lenders, everybody. What do they all have in common? I bring them all to the table to solve your real estate problem. You're hearing it during the broadcast today, and you'll hear me emphasize it throughout my tips when I'm talking about doing podcasting, but it's true. Whenever you do business with me on the podcast, in real estate, in real life, whenever you call me, reach out to me, or just connect with me, you will learn very quickly that it's always all about you.
Welcome back to Freedom Business. Connect with us on LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter at Jim Fried or at Freedom Business, and on Instagram at JimFried1. Now, back to your host, Jim Fried.
All right, we're back. We're talking personal branding by using your podcast, Mendoza. Psst.
Hey, hey, hey.
There he is. So I think that it's really important before you start projecting your brand on a podcast or whatever it is you're going to use, is what is your brand? And I think that you got to take a step back. And I think that if people watch this podcast, they will see that it's really easy to tell what my brand is. I say it over and over again. I even say, hey, my personal brand is. And then I say it. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, it's that I help I self-actualize by helping other people achieve their dreams and goals. I say it by saying, when you call me, it's always all about you. And then that I solve people's real estate problems. All the same thing. And I say it over and over again, and I deliver it. Mm-hmm. And people go, well, Jim, how do you reach customers and how do you know that they're getting your podcast? I don't know that they're watching it, but I know they know about it. And I know that when it's on point for something I'm talking to them about, that they're getting it because I direct message in them. We create the LinkedIn message and then I text it to them. So I know that they're getting it when the message is about them. I'm direct messaging them so that they get the picture.
Absolutely.
And it's extremely important and it's useful. I almost always get a response when I send it out to the people.
Yeah, I think that's a good point too, is that not only does the podcast become, you know, marketing content and branding content, but the individual segments, maybe question and answers. Maybe you have like a moment where there's a very specific Q&A that's answered. That also, just that clip, maybe it's 5 minutes. Maybe that also becomes its own form of marketing content, whether it's direct marketing, like you're saying, like doing literally directing, you know, a DM or an email or even a text, you know, a direct marketing in that way, or whether it's, you know, more broad social media marketing, you know, using it to promote your business, you know, through Instagram, through LinkedIn, through Facebook, through YouTube, through the outlets where your audience is.
And also, you know, the message that I project is multidimensional. Not only is it the spoken word and my guest, but it's also the background. You know, we went very carefully to plan the backdrop here. We'll take a look at it for a second there. You know, you got the Freedom Business logo. You got when I was on the front page of the business section of the Herald. You got my, hey, this is cool. This is a cool guy with Bruce Springsteen. You got the Marlins all over the place there. You got Vivian and my mom and Vivian and mom and Vivian right there. You got Don Shula. You can't, there he is. Mom and Vivian.
There he is. We got him.
There's Vivian. Don Shula is back there. So you got all the really cool things that really impact me. My artwork that I bought, supporting the education fund. So a lot of the things that make me are back there in a very subtle way.
Yeah.
And, you know, you and I went through that. I didn't come up with all that. That's not there by accident.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's something that's pretty, it's kind of overlooked and some people really jump into it, but you know, when you see authors, especially now that we're seeing, even on, you know, Good Morning America or what have you, we're seeing more and more people using a Zoom style format. You're seeing authors sitting behind their books, you know, or a backdrop or, you know, some sort of signage that's not only promoting who they are and who their brand is, but maybe their, you know, latest course or their latest, whatever is they're particularly talking about, whatever thing, useful tool that they're trying to promote to an audience. So yeah, absolutely. I think that background is a really important part of it when you're, you know, when you're on video, you know.
Now, then I also take all of my little visual cues and I take them with me to events. So at BizNow, I'm always at BizNow. I have a table at BizNow. I take my backdrop to BizNow, and you know, I use that. And again, they have the visual cues, the colors, and the different things that I did, and it really all ties it together. And the message will change over time, depending on what I'm doing my podcast about or doing my blog. What would we call that when I do the LinkedIn stuff and I send that out? Would that be more of a blog?
When you're doing the LinkedIn, well, a blog is written. So a blog is strictly written. You know, think about what we're taking. If you took the stuff that we talk about, right, and you wrote it in a way of think about it as a magazine article. That's what a blog is. A blog is strictly written. Now, a lot of people have used blogs and then added multimedia.
Well, I have video, you know, I have, you know, usually about 300 words of inspirational content. Maybe it's 500. Then I put down my canned advertisement. I'll say it. I don't care of what I do, what some of my programs are. Sometimes always have my licensing defined so I don't violate the law.
Sure. Of course.
And, you know, but it's a motivational message usually. And I use that to create the branding. Now I'm going to check. I have now done, let's see how many, 707 of these are on my phone, literally a whole book, a novel, you know, a book. I mean, you know, look for the Freedom Business, the Jim Fried, Tchotchka book for Christmas. It's not such a bad idea, actually.
Not a bad idea. You know, that's funny because we were talking about, you know, getting ready for the show today, and I was thinking the same thing. I was like, you know, might be time to start writing the book. You know, I've been doing it long enough, and I got enough of the tips and tricks, and might be time to start doing the book.
Well, I think so. And you know, the other thing is that my message. Andreas, I love that guy. Andreas Senni. We want to give a big shout out to Andreas. We were talking about Andreas earlier today and how he does his, there he is. Yeah, we really love you, Andreas. Andreas, you know, has helped us doing a lot of different marketing and doing a lot of different idea generation. And we watch what Andreas does and we incorporate some of his ideas because he's a real good thought leader. We truly enjoy his participation. And we've got to get him and Rebecca back on the show. Maybe we can do that in September. You can coordinate them maybe at the end of September, beginning of October.
I think that's great. You know, I'm going to be seeing them tomorrow. Andreas's show is tomorrow. Every first Thursday of the month, the Real Estate Roundtable at 6 p.m. live on all your social media channels. Go to CRE Collaborative or Creco AI. So there you go, Andreas. There's your
high five to Andreas. I want to know when he's going to do an ad with us. So, you know, one of the things that are key to me being able to efficiently do this is my phone, and actually the notes section in my phone. I have a whole bunch of different things on there. Right. I have what I call standard closes that I cut and paste into the different things.
Yep. Yeah. I don't mean to cut you off, but you and I have talked about this in the past as far as like scripts. And it's something I always recommend to people, which is just have something that have something that you always say when you open up your shows, have something that you always say if you're going to break, have something that you always say when you're closing out your show, have things that you always say when you have a sort of script when you're bringing on your guest. You don't always have to say it word for word, but if you have an idea or bullet points or, hey, I know I want to hit these thoughts, then it makes it much easier than just showing up and just turning on the mics and trying to freestyle it every time.
Wait a minute now.
I know you're fantastic at it, but you've also been doing it for 13 years. So there's a huge difference between someone who's been doing it, you know, what have we said, you know, maybe near 1,000 episodes? Is that?
Yeah, close to it.
I think so, right?
And that's like 3,000 interviews.
Or as opposed to someone who's still in, you know, double digits. Both are honorable. You don't get to 1,000 if you don't do one.
Two.
You don't get to two. You don't get to any of it, right? But some things to sort of help you out as you get started are having some sort of canned, I don't want to say canned, but having some things that you can rely on.
Can I give an example? You're struggling. So let me give you an example. Okay. And this is way before you. This is with Mike T. I used to call him Mike T because he'd always wear the same nasty white T-shirt, but I love Mike T. And what we used to do when we were getting started, he was my first engineer, him and Larry. Remember Larry?
Oh, of course.
And Larry. High five to Larry and Jim and all the and Mike T and all our friends from back in the day.
The 880 crew.
But we did a lot of different things to boost my visibility one time. I brought in all the social media people for episode 100. Mm-hmm. And they all came in and we all boosted the show on that. I met Johnny 305, God rest his soul. Johnny taught me how to talk in Twitter.
Yeah.
you know, we changed the message and we changed how we did it.
Yeah.
And one of the things that I think is very important, we'll talk about that after the break, is mixing it up, modifying your message and how you can evolve over time. So with that, I'm going to say, Mr. Mendoza, it's yours. You'll give me the opportunity to pay some bills and then we'll come back. All right, we're having a great show today. We're talking about how to build your personal brand by using your blog and doing blogging. It's really been very effective for me. We'll talk about how I know it was effective. I'm going to write that down. Sorry, just needed to take that note. It's good stuff. Hey, you know what else is good stuff? Our relationship with Warren Henry. We're family over there. They make us feel like $1 million whenever I even get near the place, I start feeling good. Why? Because Eric Day, Warren Zinn, and Larry Zinn go out of their way to make it a positive experience. When you walk into their store, you'll feel that you're a member of the Warren Henry family. You know, that's important because when you're looking to buy or lease a car, you always want to get every advantage that you possibly can. That's why my friends and I go to Warren Henry. Land Rover, Range Rover, Infiniti, and Jaguar up at 151st and Biscayne. Up in Gainesville, they sell Audi. I'm going to go up at Gainesville in a couple of weeks and check them out and hopefully buy one. And down in the Keys, they sell them all. Really like the Jeeps that they have down there. They're really beautiful cars. What do all these cars have in common? Well, they're all great cars, and they all come with the Warren Henry Advantage. That is a long list of services. It's like a whole page of stuff, but it starts with of course, a complimentary service loaner. They'll give you free keys. They'll replace your keys for free if you lose them. They'll polish up your rims if you scrape them up. They'll make sure, guarantee, in fact, that you get a great price on your trade-in, that you get a great price on your new car, and they'll give you 3 days to return your car if you don't like it. Nobody ever does that because they love their cars. Join me, my beautiful wife, Vivian, my mom, lots and lots of my friends. You know, one of my guys called me when he was on the service line the other day. What do they say about Warren Henry? Well, they say always the best price, always the best service, always Warren Henry.
Carlson from Carlson Integrated. You know, a lot of our clients find that they can do anything, but not really everything. And we are always excited to jump in and help. So whether you need another set of hands for a project or even comprehensive marketing management, our team of marketing mavens would love to have a conversation with you to see if we are the right fit. We do everything from logo and design work to email outreach and social media to writing and thought leadership. And here's a fun one. We are now offering our fabulous ebook of top 10 marketing tips on our website for free. So head over to carlsonintegrated.com and grab a copy today. And please always let us know how we can help. My email is Becca, that's B-E-K-A-H @carlsonintegrated.com. That's B-E-K-A-H @carlsonintegrated.com.
Hi, I'm Jim Fried. My personal brand is that I self-actualize by helping other people achieve their dreams and goals. I do that for real estate operating companies, family offices, and high net worth investors from all over the world. I have clients from the Middle East, the Far East, Latin America, of course, the United States. We're currently doing deals across the United States, Chicago, Texas, Georgia, the Mid-Atlantic, everywhere. Not everywhere, everywhere our clients are. You know, what I do, people ask me, Jim, what do you do? What I do is I help people solve their real estate problems. So if you're having an issue with your real estate deal, call me. I've got the gray hair to prove it. I've been to the movie more than a couple of times. And remember, whenever you call me, it's always all about you.
Welcome back to Freed on Business. Connect with us on LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter at Jim Fried or at Fried on Business, and on Instagram at Jim Fried One. Now, back to your host, Jim Fried.
Hi, welcome back to Fried on Business. Today's show is about building your personal brand by using a podcast or a blog. We're here. I'm talking to my collaborator, Mr. Reagan Mendoza. Mr. Reagan Mendoza. Hey, dude, where are you?
I'm right here.
High five. So we're talking about a lot of different things. One of the things that prompted me to do this show today is I've probably gotten 6 or 7 people in the last couple of weeks that have reached out to do a personal blog or a podcast or with me or to start one or to ask me tips on how to do it. And I believe the reason is that the economy and humanity is evolving. We're in a new place. I really think that this is the time. Even the press is now saying that the people that were as scared as possible, the overall people that were scared of going out in the pandemic is only down about 17% now. Vivian and I are even getting out there. We're not really what I would call afraid. We're just cautious because of Vivian and you know, her lack of immunity. But I've gone out now to football games, baseball games. I'm going to go to a networking event for the first time. I'm going to stay in a hotel in a few weeks when I go up to Gainesville. Woo-hoo! Oh, yeah, and I'm going to visit my, in the fraternity, they call him a big brother. One of my closest friends of all time lives in Orlando, and I'm going to go see him. Usually we would go to the football games. He stopped getting his season ticket, so we're going to go up, probably stay overnight and watch the game at his house. And I'm going to surround myself with somebody who believes in me, somebody who helped me build my original brand. My brand is really built on kindness and love.
Nice.
It is. That's what it's all really all about. It says on my LinkedIn profile, mentor. I'm going to go up to the UF conference. I'll see a bunch of the young kids up there. Maybe I'll be lucky enough to get a couple of them on tape. We'll tape some interviews with them, some interviews with some of the other real estate operating company thought leaders that'll be up there. It'll be really cool. I'm very, very excited to see them all. But you really have to think about before you get started is what are you really trying to project?
Yeah.
What are you trying to project? And then you have to say that over and over again. So what am I trying to project? I try to project my personal brand, my self-actualized by helping other people achieve their dreams and goals. I surround myself with experts. I listen to what they have to say. People can read the tea leaves. A lot of the people that we have on the show are people that I do business with, people I'm currently transacting with. They won't go on the show. But once I finished or I'm prepping with them, they will. And you'll see in the coming months, we're going to restock our bunch of guests. We'll have lenders on. We'll have investors. We'll have market practitioners. But again, what do? I'm using the podcast to build relationships and create content for them. And I have a list of a lot of them right here that we'll do it with. What are one of the main things that you've learned by doing these podcasts now? Because when we first met, you were really a production engineer and a producer at the 880 The Biz. 880 was trying to start this thing about having entrepreneurs create content. I really don't think it had a lot of traction with them for whatever reason. But then the pandemic hit and everybody became a podcaster.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, one thing I found is that there's an idea with some people that they can't do it. They don't have anything interesting to say. Oh, you know, no one wants to listen to me. And that's not really the case. Everyone has a story. Everyone has a story to tell. Everyone has something that is going to be valuable. Everyone has a voice, and that voice is going to be valuable to someone else. And sometimes it's just a message of zeroing in on that.
You know, I'm going to use another Bruce Turkellism here. And it's really about getting people to like you. Bruce calls it hearts, then minds.
Agreed.
You need to really be able to project who you are, have people connect with that, have them feel good about it, and then go from there. And I got to tell you, I don't know how many people can do what we've been able to do. I've been at this now for a long time. I've been through Vivian's need for the kidney, looking for the kidney, getting the kidney. It allowed me to project who I really am. It allowed people to go on a journey with me. My gosh, this is really good stuff. You know, these are things I don't really think about. You know, people went on the journey with us. They were invested with us. I must tell you is that I went to an event yesterday where somebody I hadn't seen in years asked me, they start out with, how's your wife? Mm-hmm. Now, nobody really starts out in business with, how's your wife? They ask you what you're working on. How are you? Where have you been? With me, it's almost always, how is your wife? Mm-hmm. When people mean that in just the kindest way, I think it's important to talk about this at least a little bit.
Sure.
The podcast helped me find her kidney. We were going to talk about this. Let's talk about this now. The platform. Okay. Mm-hmm. We're on all these different platforms. When I went and searched for the kidney, I used LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, other stuff too. Finally, it was Craigslist that did it. But let's take a step back and talk about how we use the platforms, how you connect the platforms, how you get me across the platforms. And we're getting messages from people right now on Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube. How do you work all that? How does that happen? And you do that. I don't.
Yeah, I'm actually doing it as we speak. First of all, it's pretty simple. Is you have to know where you want to go, what social media channels that you want to hit. I am of the mind that you can't really be on too many, but you don't necessarily have to be an expert in all of them. For instance, we're on Twitch. We're not super active on Twitch, but we broadcast on Twitch every week because the idea is that, you know, 2 years, 3 years from now, Twitch becomes really valuable to business. Well, we've already been on the platform, and it'll be an easy pivot for us to start to really invest more time into that. So there are different things called multi-streaming tools that we use, which is basically we create a virtual studio, which is what you see right now. And, you know, we have our logo and all of the things. And we're on a multi-streaming tool right now. We create our virtual studio. We set everything up. We link through here in a very Zoom similar fashion, as you can tell with the boxes and everything like that. And then we broadcast. We use this tool to stream to multi-channels, multi-streaming tool. So we use this to stream live to Facebook, Facebook page, Facebook profiles, LinkedIn, YouTube, Twitch, Twitter, live to your website. And then we can then take this, the video and the audio afterwards, and then send all of that out to, again, an edited version out to YouTube, an evergreen version out to Facebook, LinkedIn, all of those things, as well as also hit Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, Luminary, everywhere that anyone could get audio or video, we're there.
So the thing that I want to point out is that it started out clunky as just a radio show. And then it was audio, and we have every one of these on audio back wherever it is. That was we had a little bit of trouble when we went to migrate, because some of the stuff was in such an old format.
Right.
But now we've got everything, and I think that it's important to note that you've added all these elements. So literally, my show looks like an episode of Miami Vice. I hope we don't get a copyright infringement for mentioning Miami Vice. I mean, they seem to hit us for something every. I mean, we. That's something else that I think is important, is that we've gone and we've really sanitized a lot of the stuff that we use so we don't infringe on audio or video copyrights. And by the way, we did use something for the website that was a picture that we thought was just a picture. And it turns out that we got hit by the AP. They're chasing us. So I'm going to have to send Olivia or somebody. I mean, Rebecca's got to negotiate with. I mean, it was an honest mistake. And we took it right down the minute they notified us.
Yeah, I mean, when we were on radio, we had radio licenses, which are not the same as when you're on the internet. You need different licenses. And also, internet licenses are actually they're difficult to come by to just have a blanket license to use, you know, music for all of this. It is definitely its own hurdle to overcome, but there's also workarounds, which is what we've developed. It's stuff like this that, you know, you learn as you go along, or again, you know, you seek out someone that's already done it and already knows how to do it.
Well, you know, you've been to the movie. I've been to the movie. We've got a lot of people that are looking to get involved. Some of them are talking about becoming sponsors. Some of them are talking about coming on the show on a regular basis and creating content with us. They have great content distribution channels. So we will be back after this. We're going to talk a little bit about distributing the content and working with others to maximize the people that view your podcast. And we'll do that right after this. Well, when you look at that video, can you find the real estate opportunity? Sorry, I just have to laugh. I look at those videos and all I do is think about deals I've done there or that I want to do there. What a beautiful park we have. What a beautiful waterfront we have. High five to the folks that run that, Joe Carollo and the rest of the waterfront folks that run Bayfront Park. They do a great job there. You know who else does a great job? Our friends at Warren Henry. They've been a sponsor now for, this is our 11th season with Warren Henry. That's our 14th overall. Thank you to Larry Zinn, our good friend. Thank you to Eric Day, one of the smartest people I know. And thank you to Warren Zinn, who sets the tone about Warren Henry's being a part of a family. When you're looking to buy or lease a car, you always want to make sure you get every advantage that you can. Let me tell you where that's going to happen. Warren Henry. Land Rover, Range Rover, Infiniti and Jaguar up at 151st and Biscayne. Up in Gainesville, they have a great Audi store. I'm going to go up there and look at the new cars, see maybe I'll get an Audi this time. And down in the Keys, well, they got everything down there. Jeeps, you know, those really hot Jeeps that you see. Well, you can get one down there from Warren Henry. They'll ride it up here if you don't want to go down to the Keys. delivered up here. What all those cars have in common? Well, they're all great cars. They all come with Warren Henry Advantage. It's a long list of services. It includes, of course, the service loaner. If you have to leave your car, they'll give you a loaner. If you lose your keys, they'll replace them. Those computerized keys are really expensive. They've got a service where that if you scrape up your rims, well, if you scratch your rims, they'll help you polish them up. They'll guarantee you're getting the best price on your trade-in, the best price on your new car. And if you don't like that car, they'll give you 3 days to return it. But guess what? Nobody ever does that. They love those cars. I love my cars. I keep getting them over and over again from those guys. So remember, join me, my mom, my beautiful wife, Vivian, lots and lots of my friends. We're all members of the Warren Henry family. You should be too. Always the best price, always the best service. Always Warren Henry.
It's time to stop the hate and spread some love. You are beautiful, you're smart, you are awesome, and you never have to change for anybody. You have the voice and you have the power. We are so much stronger when we come together. It's your choice, so choose to be inspired. Choose to be accepting, be strong, be brave, be awesome, be daring, be kind. Choose kindness.
You know, we have that on Carrie Underwood, and we talk about kindness. It's really important. It's something we project here on the show. It's part of what we do as a brand on both Freedom Business and Sandstone Realty Advisors. It's my mantra. We deal with people from all over the world. Golly, I've had people do my podcast from Europe, Asia, Latin America, Far East, the Middle East, all over the country. It just doesn't stop. The blog gets to everybody. The podcast gets to everybody. My content gets to everybody. And what does it do? It's all about one thing. It's projecting that if you reach out to me, I can help you solve your real estate problem. And when we do business together, there's one thing I can guarantee you. It's always going to be all about you.
Welcome back to Freedom Business. Connect with us on LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter at Jim Fried or at Fried on Business, and on Instagram at Jim Fried One. Now, back to your host, Jim Fried.
All right, we're here with the final segment of our show, Building Your Brand with a Podcast. I want to bring back on Mr. Reagan Mendoza. He's my collaborator on this. Mr. Mendoza, hey. How are you?
Hey, good.
So, you know, we gave a lot of things that we were going to hit, and then we didn't go hit them. So let's kind of go through them one at a time. We set up the studio. You helped me do that. We bought some lights.
A little bit. Yeah. Just a little professional backdrop, some quality audio, some quality video, and then I think that you're good.
You know, how do we promote the show? Well, we send it to my entire book of people that originally had lots and lots of people opting out, but that was because they got it through multiple channels. Now that it's been so many years, not a lot of people opt out anymore. The people that get it want it. And they all have chosen which channel they get it at. Some get it on email, some get it on social media, but now they've checked it. You know, I really want to talk about this. What makes a podcast successful? I talked to my good friend, Brewster Kell, and I complained. I go, Bruce, I see all these people, they make money off their podcast, they get paid per click, they're influencers, whatever. I said, I'm jealous. Granted, you're not supposed to be jealous, but hey, it's a natural thing. Sometimes you get jealous. Mm-hmm. So I go, I really want to monetize this. He says, Jim, take a step back for a minute. I go, okay, fine. He goes, have you ever met anybody using your podcast? I go, you mean like the guy from New Zealand that I closed the deal with last year? He goes, yeah, like that guy. I go, okay, I think I got it. So, yeah. You know, I think I monetize the podcast pretty well. I use it to build relationships. I use it to create an aura of an expert, that I'm an expert. I prove that I am. I create an online persona that is transparent and honest and complete. This is me. There's no like nothing there. That's me.
Yeah.
And so people see what they get. And that's why I've got clients from all over the world who trust me. I mean, the reality is that the guys in Latin America, when they're talking to their company that owns the division that they work for, they go, "Hey, this is the guy we're working with." The people in the Middle East, they go, "Hey, Dad, this is the guy I'm working with." The people that are throughout the state of Florida that I've known for 1,000 years, "Hey, this is Jim," and I say hello to them like this. And I select it. I don't intrude on them. I do it on a select basis, a little bit at a time. But I do it over and over again. And I make it on point when I do.
Yeah.
And that's really the key to success. The key to success is keeping relevant, keep changing, keep evaluating. You know, the next thing I'm going to evaluate is my terminology that I use below the daily post. You know, there's the daily post, then there's the how to get me, and then my licenses and what we're doing. And I'm going to reevaluate that. I use a whole lot of hashtags like New York to Miami, Chicago to Miami, blah, blah, beep, beep, pop. And I think I'm going to drop some of that and focus on new things and create new hashtags. So all that hashtag really is I'm creating a chat room.
I mean, if you're engaged with your marketing as you are, and you're engaged with your brand projection, it you're going to have to. It doesn't end. Things change. So you're going to have to change with it. So having a reevaluating what you're doing every quarter, twice a year is, you have to, you know, things change.
Well, things change, things evolve. One thing that hasn't changed is me. I'm the same person that I was earlier on when episode one, I'm the same person that was on episode 500, but I'll never forget that live from the ball and chain. Jim brought this whole big sign. We had the lighted sign. We had the thing at ball and chain. They brought me the Jim Free drink, which they lit on fire. It was really great. I had the best time.
That is great.
I had the best time. And we're heading that way. We're closing in. We're at, I guess now show 700, 800. I don't even know anymore.
I think something. Yeah. Yeah.
700.
We'll have to go back and count.
We're going to have to go back and count. But the main thing is that one thing persists. The show is not really about me. It's still about other people. It's still about helping other people. It's providing content to them that they find useful. That allows me to present them with what I do throughout the podcast through an ad. And that's really what we're doing. What we're really doing is projecting who I am, what I do, and how I do it on a professional basis through the podcast, which is really a complimentary thing that I do. So, you know, that's it. It's still all about the other person. It's about the listener. And it's about creating information that they'll want to do. So we're going to take the next few weeks. We're going to take a step back. We're going to load it up for the final push for next year, for the end of this year. We'll create some great content. If there's something anybody wants to hear, they should DM me or text me. We'll put together a show for the people that listen. And Mr. Mendoza, I want to thank you for all the help that you've given me in producing the content, projecting the content, making sure I look good. It's really important. And I really do believe that it's impossible to do this on your own. You really do need to have a collaborator. And I really can't thank you enough, Mr. Mendoza.
It's my pleasure. It's been great collaborating with you. I think we have a very similar mindset in that we look to solve for yes. You know, can we do this? Yes, of course we can. Now let's figure out how we can do it.
Well done. I think we're going to end right there. I want to thank Mr. Mendoza, my partner in crime here today. I want to thank all of our sponsors, especially Warren Henry Automotive, our friends at Deep Locks, our friends at Carlson Integrated. I want to thank you, our listener viewer, for being here with us through all these years. I want to remind everybody that the new content will be created next Wednesday at noon. What'll it be? We're figuring that out now, but I'm sure it'll be engaging and fun. And something that you can use to right then that will make your day a little bit better and help you do better in business. Remember, I do this because I love it. And the person, I got myself all confused there. The person wants to do something, finds a way. The other finds an excuse. Now go out there and make it happen. God bless you. And God bless the United States of America. Mr. Mendoza, the rest is yours.
Bye.